To only display the data on the console. The data to be displayed may be very large, and only a limited amount of data can be displayed on the console since the memory is volatile. So it is impossible to recover the programmatically generated data again and again. If you do programming with the large amount of data, then it programmatically it is not possible. Okay, so that's where file handling plays an important role when the data needs to be stored permanently into the file. Okay, means a file is a named location in a disk to store related information. We can access that stored information after the program termination. Okay, and coming to the implementation is slightly lengthy or complicated in the other programming languages, but it is easier and shorter in Python. Okay, and hence there are some operations can be done in files. That is, first one is mean all operations can be done in an order, that is opening file. And the next one is writing on the file, and after that finally close the file. See here, there are some modes. That is the read. R stands for generally. This is in a default mode. It opens the file for reading. And coming to the W, this mode opens the file for writing. And if the file doesn't exist, then it creates a new file. If that file exists, then if that particular file exists, then the matter in that file is deleted and the new data will be added. And coming to the X, it creates a new file. If file already exists, the operation fails. Okay. And yeah, I will explain all these modes in detail. Let me give somewhat theoretical knowledge about these modes. So T here stands for, this is a default mode. It opens this text mode, and B, it opens the binary mode generally. Okay. And coming to the operations, first one is the opening file. Let me open my PyCharm. Okay. Python provides an open function that accepts two arguments, okay, file name and access mode in which the file is accessed. Means you can give any type of mode like reading, writing, appending, anything. And so it generally has two arguments. For the first one is the file name, and the second one is the access mode. And the function returns the file object, which can be used to perform various operations like reading, writing, appending, etc. Okay. Let me give an example so that you can understand better. Here I am giving file. Let me create a file first. My laptop is too slow. You please be patient. Let me create a file that is file. Text file, okay. See, I have created a text file, and here I just want to write Python. Hello. Okay, now clear. Let me open a file using the open mode. Here I am mentioning it. See, yeah, open of, let me give that file name, that is I just want to open it in a view. One second, guys.
हमें क्लियर ना?
या ओके हियर इंस्टेड ऑफ वन ओ हियर आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू गिव फाइली एंड हियर आई ओपन माई फाइल इन द रीड मोड. ओके ओके माई लैपटॉप या ओके दिस इज हाउ वी कैन ओपन ए फाइल हियर फाइल इज ओपन बट वी कॉन्ट रीड बिकॉज हियर आई एम नॉट गिविंग एनी रीड फंक्शन इन दिस वे वी कैन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ओपन एनी फाइल देन इन दिस वे यू कैन ओपन द फाइल बाई यूजिंग ओपन मोड देन यू कैन ओपन द फाइल This is all about the open method, and the second one is the close method. Means there are. I will explain this close method at last. First of all, let me explain what is. I mean, this read method, write method. I mean, writing the file, reading the file, everything. So let me comment on this. Here, I just want to read the content in this file. So here I am giving this read. So okay. Let me print output. Oh, sorry, sorry. See, I got the output that is what is this Python? One is a hello world. Means here I am reading that content in that file. Means I perfectly performed the read operation in that file also. Okay. Okay. Now everything is clear till now. This is how we can read the file using for loop. Also, we can read the file. I will explain it after. I will explain after performing the write operation. Okay. Generally if to write some text to a file we need to open the file using the open method with one of the following mode access that is actually there are two modes one is write I mean w and the second one is a what w means let me explain if at all if you want to add anything here I just want to perform I mean here I just want to write something on this file so here I am giving write operation now Let me write that is f dot write off. Here I just want to add that is what development. Okay. Now let me print my file. See in the file in that file everything is I mean before what the content that is hello world one is a python I think so everything is deleted and the new this is and the web dev I mean development is added here if at all if you perform w I mean if at all if you perform w mode it will overwrite the file if any file exists okay the file point I mean and after that the file pointer is at the beginning of the file okay See, this is how this is the this is what W O mode. Now here, let me delete this W mode. Here, I just want to add what is development to that file. Here, there is another file that is ABC. There is something on this that. Here I just want to add this development to that ABC file. Let me change my file. So yeah, here let me give an operation that is A. Now let me perform my operation. Now just go back to the what is this ABC. See development is added here means if at all if you perform the a then it will append the existing file That means it creates a new file if generally there is another option for this a mode, that is if it creates a new file if there is no file exist. If there is a file exist, then it will add that content to that file. But coming to the w operation, it deletes the existing file and it overwrites the new informations to that existing file. Okay, I hope you understand the difference between the w and a. Let me delete all this stuff. Okay. The difference between the W and A mode, we have, first of all, we have opened the file in the W mode. Then the file, I mean, the, then the, then in, I mean, then the file is, there is a, some content in that file. Then it, it deletes that content and it overwrites the new content. And coming to the A mode, then here there is some text existing in that file and it appends that particular text to that file. This is the major difference between the A and W. This is how we can perform the write operation in the file. Okay, actually there are two types. One is the read on, one is, I mean, one is W mode and the other one is A mode. Okay. Let me delete all this. Let me first of all open my file. That is open. Open of what? Here I just want to give. Let me add some. Sorry. Here let me give filing. And put this one in a read mode. Now let me give, now here I just want to read only two letters. So let me give N. N. Read of two. Now print N. See, the output is DE. Means if at all if you want to read only that particular information, then you can give that number, so that if here I just gave two, so that's why it is reading the two letters in that in development. Okay, this is another operation that we can perform using in files. And there is another operation, that is read file through the for loop. That means we can read the file using for loop also. Let me explain how we can perform. Here, let me give for I in field. Let me print I here. See, we got the output, that is development. Means we can perform read operation using for loops also. But if you want to read any information, you can read, you can use the read function. On the other hand, you can use the for loop also. Okay, actually for reading, there are two methods. One is read method and the second one is the for method. Okay, we can read the content using for loops or even also read method. I hope everything is clear till now. Coming to the write operation, actually there are two modes. One is the W mode and the second one is the append mode. But generally W means it overwrites the content, and coming to the A mode, it just append the new content to, it just append the new content to the old content. This is the difference between A and W. And we can and another thing is we can even read that particular, we can read sub information. We can say that the sub information, if at all if you want to read that particular information, then you can give that particular number, so only you can read that number of lines. Okay, And the next one is read lines of the files. Okay, generally Python facilitates to read the file line by line by using the function that is read line method. There is another method, read lines. I will explain it after explaining the read line method. The read line method reads the line of the file from the beginning. Okay, if you use the read line method two times, then we got the we get the first two lines of the file. Let me add some more lines to this file, that is Python somewhat. Here I just added some more lines to this Python file so that you can understand what is this read line method. Okay, consider this following example, that is a file. Let me delete all this. Okay, now here I just want to perform, now here I just want to store the data of the file into a variable content, a variable that is here con and file dot read line. Okay, see here we got read line. Let me print this. See here I got the output, that is the development, because development is the first line in that file. See, in that file development is that first line now. So we got the output. Let me give again read. Let me one equals to file of read line. Okay, let me print this one also. See, we got the output one. Development and Python. Like I have earlier, I said that if you use the read line method two times, then we get the first two lines of the file. The first here, see, what is the first two lines of this file? Python and development and Python, right? So we got the output perfectly. This is what in a read line means. Okay, generally read line means reading lines from the file. Okay, if at all if you want to read the content line by line, then you can use this read line method. So this is all about the read line method. And there is another method, that is the read lines. Generally Python provides also the read lines method, which is used for the reading lines. It returns the list of the lines till the end of the file. End of the file is reached. Let me perform this read line also. See read lines. Let me comment this. This also. See, I got the output, that is development, Python, somewhat whatever. Okay, this is all about the read lines. Okay, it generally used for the reading lines. If you perform the read line, then it will read the first line of the code. If at all if you perform the read lines, then it will read the all lines of the code. This is the major difference between the read line and the read lines. This is also used for the reading on a file. Okay, now everything is clear till now. I hope everything is clear till now. Let me delete all this. Now, till now I just manually typed the code in the file. Generally, how to create a new file? Okay, if at all if you want to create a new file, there are some modes. Using those modes, we can create in a file. The new file can be created by using some modes. I will explain them each and every. I will explain them. There is the first thing, that is generally X and A and W. I have already explained that is what is A and what W. But I will explain how to create a file using the A mode and the W mode. And coming to the X mode, it creates a new file with the specified name, and it causes an error if file exists with the same name. Let me explain. Here I am giving that file equals to open out. Here I just want to read. Sorry. And Generally, I have already explained that if at all if you want to open a file, there are two arguments. First one is the file name, and the second one is the mode. Let me print this file. See here where. See here. See. New file V is created here. I think everyone is. I think my screen is visible. See, V is created. I mean, V wa. File is created here. See, this is all about the X mode. Like if using X mode, we can create a new file. I mean, let me give that is. See, here I got the output that is the file exist one. Means I have said that earlier. I said that if at all if you perform the X operation, then it will cause an error if that file exists with the same name. So that's why I have said that if at all if you want to create a new name, you have to give some some new file name. Okay, you are not supposed to give the existed file name. This is what then X mode means. Okay, let me perform. Let me explain the reason. Another that is an A mode. Generally, it creates a new file with the specified name. If no such file exists, then it appends that content to the file. If that file is already, if that file is already exists, then it then the content is appended. Or else, it will create a new file if that file is not exist. Let me explain. Let me delete all this here. I just want to perform A mode. Okay. Let me give that is file equals to open off. Sorry. Open off. Now here I want to perform operation A. Sorry. File dot write off. Let me print this screen. See here, what is this file name? Wow. Yeah. Here new file is created with that some content. This is all about the A mode. Like if there is a file exist, then it just appends the content to that existing file. If there is no existing file, then it will create a new file. Then it appends that particular content to the new file. This is all about the A method. And there is another method that is the W. Like we can create a file using W mode also. Like it creates a file with the specified name if no such files are exist. See, let me perform what is this W operation. If that particular file exists, then it overwrites the existing file. Okay. What operation? A, right? See, new file A is created with that with some content. This is all in this way we can create new files. There are actually three types there are actually three modes that we can use to create a file. That is the one, first one is X, second one is A, and the third one is W. What X means, it creates a new file with the specified name. Okay, and if it causes an error if that file exists with the same name, or else it will create a new file with the specified name. And coming to the A mode, it appends the content of the file if there is an existing file. If there is no existing file, then it will create a new file, and then it will append that particular content to that new file. This is the A mode. And coming to the W mode, it creates a new file with the specified name if no such file is exist. If there isn't any file exist, then it overwrites the existing file. This is the difference between the X mode, A mode, and W mode. you please do practice so that you can understand it better and you may not confused. Okay, so you just do practice. Do practice on how to read files. What is this read line, read lines, and everything. X mode, A mode, W mode, R mode. How to open a file? How to add content to that file? Everything. So that only you can understand the depth in this file handling. Okay. And coming to the last topic in this file, that is file pointer positions. Okay. Generally, Python provides the tell. Let me delete all this. Okay. Just leave. It provides the tell method, which is used to print the byte number at which the at which that particular pointer currently exists. Let me give an example. Int Python. Hello. Currently file at the 0 byte. Read all the lines in the file. Let me give something. Yeah. Now here I just read all the operations. Now let me print this tell operation. Not reading. Okay. One second, guys. Okay, here I am giving W mode, right? You are let me change my see here I got the output that is 34. Generally at starting Python, I mean this file is pointed at the 0. After reading all the lines, it pointed at the what is this position 34. This is what an app, I mean what is this tell method means. It generally prints that byte number at which the file pointer currently exists. This is all about the Python pointer positions. Generally we can modify the file pointer positions, like in real world applications sometimes we need to change the file pointer location externally, since we may need to read or write the content in various locations. For this purpose, here Python provides us the seek method. Okay, seek method, which enables us to modify the file pointer position externally. Let me explain what is this file pointer. If at all if you want to change the file pointer, then you can use this seek method. Here I just want to perform what is this. Let me do. Here I want to perform seek operation. See, I just want to change the 10. Now just print. We got the output that is a 10, means we can change the file pointer using this seek method. Okay, this is all about the file handling. means how to create a file. Actually, there are three methods, that is A mode, W mode, and X mode, and how to read the file. Generally, using read method also, we can use the you can read the file, and there is another method, that is using for loops also, we can read the file. And there is another concept, that is the read line and read lines. But I have clearly explained the difference between read line and read lines. If we perform read line method, then content is read by the line by line. If at all, if you perform the read lines, then the whole content is readed at once. And after that, I have explained this tell method and what is this seek method. This is all about the Python handling. If you do, you please do practice so that you can understand these topics. Okay. Now I'm going to explain you guys about the modules. Coming to the introduction, actually modules, there are two types. I explained. Coming to the introduction, Python module can be defined as a Python program file which contains a Python code, including Python functions, class, or variables. In other words, we can say that our Python code file saved in the extension, that is here, this particular function strings, it is saved with the .py extension. Then we can treat this particular file as a module. Okay, what this module means, here we have a runnable code. Okay. Modules in Python provides us the flexibility to organize the code in a logical way. And to use the functionality from one module into another module, we have to import the specific module. Then only we can perform operations, okay? Let me give one example. Let me create one file. Let me create, what is this? Here, I just want to create def message. Here, I just want to give parameter, that is name. Okay. Now, print file plus what is name. Okay. Here, I created, here I just wrote some code. And here, I just want, here I am treating this one as a module. Okay. We need to include this module into our main module. To call this method display, I mean the method method, what is this method, message method. Let me create another function. Let me create another program. See, loading the module in our Python code. Okay. We need to load the module in our program code to use the functionality. Python provides two types of statement. One is the import statement, and the second one is from import statement. Coming to the first one, the first one is the import statement. This import statement is used to import all the functionality of one module to the another. Here we must notice one thing, that we can use the functionality of any program, any Python source file, by importing that file as a module into the other another Python source file. Okay. And the another thing is, we can import multiple modules with a single import statement. But a module is loaded once regardless of the number of times it has been imported into our file. Let me first of all, let me create a function here. I am using import function. Here I am importing the sum. See, here I have imported the sum. Now I just want to give, I gave a parameter, that is name, right? So I just want to print my name. Yeah. Now, what is the method name? Message. Now I just want to perform this message, that is sum dot message. What is this name? Okay. Sorry. See, here I am asking to enter my name. See, here I got the output that is hi Vanessa. This is how we can use the modules. In this particular Python file, here I gave the output that is print hi plus name. This particular function here I am imported in this in the main module. So here I got the output that is a hi Vanessa. This is how we can use this module. Like here if you we need to call this function name, okay? This is all about the import method, and there is an another method that is an from import statement. Instead of importing the whole module, here I am importing the whole module. Here I am treated some as an module using import method. Here I am importing the whole module. But coming to the from import statement, instead of importing the whole module into the namespace, Python provides here the flexibility to import the only specific attributes of a module. If you take the calculator program, in calculator program we created many functions. One is a subtraction and one is a divide and one is an adding, everything. If at all if you want to perform if you want to import that particular subtraction or addition module, then using from import statement we can do in that we can do those programs, okay? Here it is and it provides the flexibility to import the only specific attributes of the module, okay? Let me give an example. Let me create one program that is let me delete all this. Here I just want to perform calculator operation. First one is the sum. Here there are two parameters, that is a plus b. Then here I am giving return a plus b, and there is another operation that is subtraction. Again same two parameters, return a minus b. Yeah, here I created something. Now coming to our main program, that is a module. Here I am importing here I just want to import that particular module, that is the sum, okay? So using from sum, using from statement, you can using from import statement, we can perform this type of operation. So here I just want to import, what is this, add dev actually, okay? Here successfully I imported dev module. Let me delete all this. Let me give that is a equals to, let me take in user input. Okay. Now print, what is this sum? I just want to perform dev operation, right? Dev of a comma b. Sorry. Okay. Let me give a number that is 10. Let me give another number that is 2. See, here I got the output that is division is 5.0, means 10 by 2 means 5, right? This is how we can use the from import statement. Like this from import statement is always better to use if you know the attributes to be imported from the module in advance. Here I have already know the attributes that which have to imported. That is here I know that is there are what are the attributes have that is some subdivision. So in that case you can use this from import statement. Okay, and it doesn't let our code to be heavier. We can also import all the attributes from the module using star operators also. Okay, not only div. In this case, you can perform any type of operation. Here, I just want to perform sub. Let me add one number that is 2 and the second number 1. See, I got the output that is a 1. This is how, this is what the from import statement, and this is the major difference between the import statement and from import statement. Okay, using module, if you want to use the module, then we can use this two statement. That is, one is import statement and the other one is the from import statement. Okay, I hope everything is clear till now. And there is another thing in the module, that is a renaming a module. Like Python provides us the flexibility to import some modules with a specific name so that we can use this name to use that module in our Python code. Let me, one second. I think so yesterday or day before yesterday I have explained that if at all if you want to import NumPy, here I am giving that import NumPy as NumPy. This is the all about the renaming a module. Like we can okay, I think so. My screen is not visible. Okay, this is how we can rename our module. And if at all if you want to rename this sum operation, import sum as, sorry, s. This is the renaming module. Like it provides the flexibility to some you import a sum module with a specific name so that we can use this name to use this module in our Python source file. This is all about the modules and Python handling. I hope everything is clear till now. Actually, there is one module that I just want to explain you guys. That is the math module. Sorry, one second. Sorry, random module. And there is another module that is a statistics modules. There are other modules also. That is what is this OS module? I mean, math module. SYS module, everything. Here, I just want to give somewhat introduction about this random module and the statistics module. You please do practice on the math module, OS module, date and time, everything. Okay. Generally, Python random module functions depend on a pseudo random number generator. Like if you use the random function, then numbers will printed randomly. Then you can't expect which value will be printed. Let me delete this. Let me give one example. This random module, this function, I mean, if you perform the random random function, then this function generates a random float number between the 0.0 and 1.1. And if you perform the randint, there is another function that is in a randint. It returns a random integer between the specified integer. Like if you give the values that is 10 to 100, then it randomly gives any values. Either 1 to 100 means 2, 3, 16, 17, everything, anything. Randomly it gives the output. And there is another function that is in a random choice. Generally, this function returns a random selected element from a non-empty. Let me give an example for this random choice. Import module. That is random. Okay. Now, let me perform this random choice. that choice of let me give one sequence, that is 1 2 3 4 5 6 enough. See, I got the output, that is the 6. Let me print it again. This time I got the new output, that is 4. This is what the random function, random module means. If you use this random, then you will get the outputs randomly. We can't assume that what the output will be printed. Okay, this is the major difference between the random choice, randint, and random random. Okay. Now let me give somewhat introduction about this statistics module. Let me delete all this. Okay. This this Python statistics module provides the functions to a mathematical statistics of the numeric data. There are some popular statistics functions, that is the mean function, what is this median, mode, and everything. Coming to the mean function, this mean function is used to calculate the arithmetic mean. I hope everyone is familiar with this mean method. Like, what is means? Means it generally calculates the arithmetic mean of the numbers from the list, like sum of all numbers by the number of numbers. That's it. This is the what mean means. It generally gives the average. Okay. Let me perform this mean method. Let me give one list. 1 2 3 5. Let me import this module. If you don't import this module, then you can't perform these type of operations. Okay. Let me import this. Let me rename this statistics as S. S dot. Here I just want to perform the mean function on which data set list. Okay. Now let me print my output. See, I got the output, that is 2. Okay, let me change the value. Four, three, two, one. 4 3 7. 2.5. Here I got the output, that is 2.5. Module. 2.5. Guess, is this output right?
Yes, ma'am. 10 by 4, 2.5.
Yeah, I'm sorry. 10 by 4, right? I thought that 10 by 2. Thank you. And there is another function, that is the median. Like, I hope everyone is familiar with this median function. This median function is used to return the middle value, right? Yeah, middle value of the list. Okay, let me add one more value. Let me perform this median. See, I got the output, that is 3, because 3 is the middle one in this particular list. What if I gave even number? 3.5. Yeah, 3.5 is in between 3 and 4, right? So we got the output, that is 3.5. Everything is works perfectly. Okay. And there is another function, that is then a mode function. This mode function returns the most common data that occurs in the list. Like, C6 is the most I mean most common data in that in this most common element in this particular list. So we got the output that is 6. What if? Yeah, see, we got the output that is no unique mode. Found six equally common values. Okay, this is all about the mode, mean, and median. These are all about, I mean, there are and other functions in the statistics also, that is median, low, and I mean STDV function. This function is used to calculate the standard deviation on a given sample. Actually, I'm not familiar with the statistics. You please do practice. I am only familiar with this mean, mode, and median. So only, but there are other functions also, that is what is median low and median high and everything. Yeah. I hope everything is clear till now. This is all for today's lecture. Till now, I have explained about the file handling and modules. Okay. Like how to read file, how to write file, how to append new content to the existing file, how to create a file. There are actually three modes in the creating file. In two ways, we can read the file and everything. And coming to the modules, I have explained the two statements in the module. That is, one is import and the second one is from import statement. I explained what is this import module, I mean import statement, and the next one is a from import statement, the differences between those statements. And after that, I have explained this statistics and like what are all the functions which are involved in this statistics module, that is mean, mode, median. And before that, I have explained what about the random module. There are some functions which are involved in the random module, that is random choice, random int, random function. Generally, random functions are used to, if at all, if you want to create any random numbers in that particular sequence, then you can use this random module. This is all for today's lecture. I hope everything is clear till now, and my exams are coming. Santoshi ma'am will handle you tomorrow. Yeah, so tomorrow's class maybe Santoshi ma'am will take it. Okay, Santoshi ma'am. Santoshi ma'am. Sanjeev sir.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is all for today's lecture. So if you want to say anything, then you please. Or else we will end up this session.
Okay, end up the session.
Yeah, okay, guys, you can leave now. The best. Yeah, okay, thank you, thank you. What about today's task? Please do practice on Python file handling. Okay.